his goal is to come up and rap. Like I said, he'll probably be post like that. And his goal is to have his head connected, okay? My goal is not to let that happen. So go back down one more time. Right, when he comes up, I catch him, bam, with the forearm. I pummel this one underneath and I grab the shoulder. Yeah? You can keep this here. All I'm doing is just going up one level. Boom, boom. And like I said, I'm stepping up right here with this foot. Let's not be down like this with our knee. Yeah? Let's be up right here, ready to knee slice or ready to just come in. And you can even back step right here too. You got to start coming back, then back stepping for the leg. Totally up to you guys. Yeah? Go ahead and try that real quick. Any other questions? All right, guys, I'm going to go ready, break, ready. One hand, not the other. The other is posted on his hip to keep him down. Because if I don't have this hand posted on the hip, and if I'm just wizarding, and I try and turn this way like this, he's just going to come up. Boom. I just let him come up. Yeah, he felt my movement. And he's good at dogfight. He already had his arm wrapped up around my waist, so wherever I went, he can.
Yeah.
So literally, when I'm here, right when he comes up in here, he beats us. We got a frame on his hip. We got a base, our hand on the mat, and I'm turning my hips out because my knee that's stuck inside, I just want to turn it up to the sky. And what I mean by that is I'm literally just turning my hips this way, boom, and now my knee is pointed up at the sky, boom. Yeah, now that it's pointed up at the sky, I'm almost doing, I'm not jumping on top of him, but I'm thinking of hurrying my ass up and jumping on top of him. Because if you guys see, my left leg right here is gonna try and beat his leg. So I'm like this. I'm gonna try and just literally slice my knee on top right here, okay? But what I don't wanna happen is me slice and me lead this leg back and then you get a butterfly, okay? I wanna be like this, and right when I end up coming through, I wanna literally skip both of my legs through like this, boom, all the way into mount. Yeah, 3/4 mount, because he's still pinching nice and tight right here. That's still fine. Yeah, we just went to 3/4 mount, and then he just kind of come up to dogfight. So literally, we're here, right when he comes up, I'm just facing, jumping right into 3/4 mount. Here, he comes up, I'm just facing, jumping all the way up into 3/4 mount. All right, guys, pretty simple, just two posts, one's on the mat, you're almost just turning your hips, and then just jump into the feet. Yeah, maybe it's like hard right here, okay? That's when literally all we're gonna be doing is popping our knee through and almost just trying to knee slice it through this way, just like we're doing in the first position. And once we're here, I can put both hands on the mat, and I know that once I put both hands on the mat, I immediately need a back step because he can pop out the back and take my back. Yeah, exactly. And once I feel him start doing that again, go ahead and start doing that. Then I have to go back to the wizard. I can probably wizard him back down, pop my knee back up on top. This is what you want, is you want your knee up on top, all right? So when we started it here, you beat us up right here, boom. And I was trying to do that move that we just taught when we pop our knee here, he's being super tight right here. So all I'm gonna do is just try to slide my knee through, boom. Yeah, I can keep the wizard, but usually he'll probably post his elbow on the mat, nice. This is when I'm just going to drop my hand and then back step. Drop, back step, and look at my hand that I dropped is going to end up grabbing his armpit like this. Yeah? And think about having your middle finger in his armpit. Because your middle finger is the one that's the deepest finger, you know, you could get into the most. So think about middle finger grabbing deep in there. Sorry, guys. Sorry.
It's like you and me were.
That's what I'm thinking. Guys, the inches matter when we're playing jiu-jitsu, right?
Jiu-jitsu.
Here, yeah. Once we're here too with the fingers, that means that my shoulder's in perfect lining to start dropping it right into his throat. All right, damn, I got that on video too.
No, I won't. You know I don't post it. I won't post it.
So we're right here, and then his arm's diving underneath. And we're just like this, cradling, yeah? The easiest one that we could get out is probably just kicking this out, retracting, and coming right into side control, yeah? But that's gonna be kind of hard to do. So what we like to do is just pull down, C-clamp, and push it down. Yeah, so we were like this, pull, push, and then all I'm doing is dropping my knee to the mat, boom, and coming right back up into 3/4 mount, bam, yeah? So that was because he was being super tight. When he already came up, I went post. I'm trying to get my knee to three quarter knot. He's not letting me. So I'm just going to pop my knee through this way. Both hands on the mat. Back step. Grab the armpit and underscoop the leg right here. Yeah, this is reverse half guard. Yeah, I know. I didn't know that position. That was a name for that until I seen the video the other day. And I was like, oh, I guess it's called reverse half guard. So this is reverse half guard. Easiest one. Kick this open and get retract the leg. That's probably not going to work all the time. So we're going to pull, push, and I'm literally just jumping up right here, jumping up. Boom. And you guys can still keep this armpit right here, and then we can start smothering him right here. I don't know if you guys seen Gordon Ryan last night. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he was, he does this whole chopping block thing where they're like this. He likes to cup the armpit. He was cupping the armpit like this. And then the other hand was like this, cupping the head. Like literally, boom. Mm-hmm. And that's like his whole thing right here. I think Eddie Bravo calls it the chop block series or whatever.
Yeah.
It's on mastering the system. But so that literally ties right into that. Make sure you guys are playing with it. Literally, you're trying to do the first one. We're going post on the hip, but we're trying to. This head being super tight, not letting our knee wiggle at all. So we're just going to slide our knee through that first position, both hands on the mat, back step. Yeah. Any questions? We're just going to be doing that, and then we're going to start some rolls right after, right? I'm going to go. Ready.
Thank you. Thank you. That's how I smother game is so much better because it has, like,
straight in the down,
coming up and turning it down.
Yep, right.
Like, it's making it to the bridge of arrows. But just from getting destroyed by him so much. He's so good.
Well,